Bayern Munich too haven't exactly had the best of seasons this year. They finished 18th in the third tier division of the Bundesliga. That is dreadful when you come to think about it. I'm not going to lie to you guys, I am not too familiar with this team at all, so I've done a little bit of research. They've won the Bavarian Cup once in 2002. They won the Oberbayern Cup three times in 1995, 2001 and 2002. Been promoted from the regional leagues many times. But because they are a second team, they aren't eligible to play in the second division of German football. Don't ask me why, I have absolutely no idea. But in FIFA, we can promote them. So what we're going to do today, we're going to take Bayern Munich. Not only are we going to bypass Bayern Munich, we're going to make Bayern Munich 2 the best team in the world by the end of this video. If you haven't already, go check out my other rebuilds. You guys seem to be really enjoying these rebuilds. That's why I keep bringing them to you. Don't forget to tell me what team you want me to rebuild next. I'm open to any and all teams. And as always, if you do go on to enjoy today's video, be sure to leave a like and smash that subscribe button. It really does help with the YouTube algorithm. If you haven't seen one of my rebuild videos yet, here are the rules. The main objective of today's video is to win the Champions League. I can make any transfers that I want with the given budget. Every single game must be simulated, but the Champions League final has to be played. This one is going to be a very big challenge. Take a look at the team. There's not one 70 rated player in this squad. They're all dead young though, so that is very, very useful for me. I feel like there's a lot of potential. Arp, he's always had a lot of potential in career mode. I'll be honest with you though, I have not heard of a single other player in this team. I feel like there's a lot of room for improvement, but I feel like instead of going for the big transfers in this season, it's going to be putting a lot of money into the youth academy. So like I've just said, most of my money this year is going to be spent on the youth academy in hiring scouts. We're going to pick up this Belgian scout here. I'm not even going to try and pronounce his second name, but he looks to be decent, so we're going to buy him. And we're going to be sending him straight away. I'm not too sure. Maybe France or... I'm not too sure. I don't think it really matters, to be honest. I'm going to send him to Italy for 9 months just for any type of player. And I'm just hoping that within the 9 months that we pick up quite a few very good players to bolster the squad. And hopefully, we can inject them straight into the team. Okay, guys, just to catch you up, we've sold two players. We sold, first of all, Timo Kuhn for 840,000. And we've also sold Feldhahn for 140,000. They were both in the 30s. They were not going to fit into the starting 11. Plus, we've cashed in on them whilst we could. We've got just under 1 million for both of them put together. So hopefully we can put that money to good use. We're about to recall by far our best centre-back in this squad. Lars Lucas Mai, 20 years of age. He's currently on loan to SV Darmstadt 98 for whatever reason. We're going to bring him back and he's going to go straight into the starting 11 team. Okay, something else to catch you guys up on. Basically, we're clearing out all of the old into the team. So, Maximilian Welsmuller has been sold for 620,000 and so has Angelo Mai. He's been sold for 240,000. We're just getting rid of the old people in the team who were just going to decrease anyway, giving the youth a chance in the team. Plus, there are a couple of players that I want to bring in certain positions anyways. So, we're just getting a budget a little bit higher, offloading the old and in with the new. We've made our first proper signing of the season. David Schnegg from Austria, 21 years of age, 66 rated. He is by far the better option for our left-back position now. Our current left-back, I believe, is 61 rated. He's 5 overall rating higher than him, so it was a no-brainer. He cost us £2.65 million. I feel like we broke the bank a little bit, but I feel like he's going to be worth it for the next couple of seasons until we can bolster it even more. We've just brought in another midfielder, Tomasz Makowski, the Polish midfielder, 21 years of age, 65 rated. He cost us £1.25 million. I feel like that's the last player that we're going to sign from this transfer window. We sold off the older CDM. Now we're going to put this younger one in. And hopefully within the next coming seasons, he can grow and then we can offload him for even more than what we spent on him. That, my friends, is the end of the first transfer window in season one. Now the team is looking pretty solid, if I'm being totally honest. They've already jumped. Most of them have already jumped up in overall already. Arp has, Oberlin has, Kun has, Stiller has, and they're all very, very, very young as well. We've got a bit of squad depth as well. I'm not gonna lie to you, this is looking quite promising. We've reached the halfway point in season one. Now take a look at this. We're third in the league. Our short-term objective was to finish in the top half. I'd say we're smashing it right now. 37 points, we're only 5 points off top spot. Now, realistically, I didn't really want to go up in the first season. I don't want to go up in the first season because I feel like if we do, we're going to come straight back down because the quality in Division 2 probably is going to overthrow us. I'd like us to remain in third tier football in season two, grow our squad even more, and then go for it. But if we're that good now, then maybe we do deserve to go in Division 2. Who knows? Bit of bad news. Nicholas Cunn, our best right winger, has been sold for $2 million because he wanted away. We had absolutely no choice in the matter. However, there is some good news to this. I'll show you right now. Now, I was searching the transfer market for a good 10 minutes trying to find a suitable replacement. Then I've stumbled upon this guy in our team. He's on loan to Union Berlin. He's 19 years of age and he's the exact same rating as Cunn was before we sold him. So what we're going to do, we're going to bring him back and slot him straight into the starting 11. We've just come to the end of the second transfer window in season one. Just take a look at the squad, man. They've all improved massively. I think the right back position does need to be improved a little bit in comparison with the entirety of the team. But they're all ridiculously young and they're growing like mad. So the rest of the season, to be honest, we are looking at getting a promotion. Maybe I am talking a bit too confidently, I don't know. But the way it is looking very promising for us. Let's take a look at the end of the season. Well, this certainly took a turn. We've gone up as champions from the third tier division to the second. I genuinely did not see that coming at all. Okay. Our short-term goal was to remain in the top half of the league. And we've gone up as champions. Like, talk about overachieving. In fairness, though, when you do take a look at the team, like, it's actually really, really good. I mean, for third tier anyway, when you think about it, they've all grown. Like, majority of the players are over 70 rated now, when not one of them were before this season started. So they've all grown tremendously. It's just now a question if they can keep growing in season two. Who knows? Arp had a tremendous season. He grew a total of 6 overall and he scored 20 goals in 40 games. Singh, he grew 6 as well, getting 12 goals and 5 assists. Dejaku grew 4 since bringing him back from loan, scoring 7 goals. Oberlin has grown 5. Mikowski's grown 5. Schneg's grown 4. He's a really good signing for us. Scott's grown 4. He could be pretty damn good, to be fair. I'm not going to lie to you. Scott, if he keeps growing like that, could potentially replace Singh in the future. You never know. But the players, they've all grown really well. Still is 20 years of age and he's 72 rating. We're going to keep him for quite a while. I'm going to make sure of that. But everybody's grown. Look at this. Everybody's grown. I'm so happy with this. It's going to be a very interesting season next season, to say the least. I don't know where we're going to finish, but I've got a feeling it's going to be quite interesting. Let's get into season two. In season two, the board have given us a little bit more money. They've given us £8.19 million to work with. There's a couple of positions that I do want to bolster, and we're going to get straight into this. Start off our season, signing off Ismail Bulecki. He has cost us £1.5 million. The 18-year-old is 64 rated. I'm not going to lie to you guys, the reason that I bought this guy is because he's 18 years of age, and I've heard that he's got a lot of potential. And with him only being 64 rated, I'm expecting by mid-season to have shot up like a rocket. Just sold our first player of the season, Josip Stanisic. We sold him for £1.15 million. It was an offer too good to refuse, to be honest. He was overall worth us about £700,000. And they overall bid on that first time. So I just couldn't say no to it. I'm not going to lie, guys. I think we've just had the bargain of the century. Axel Twansby, 23 years of age, 75 rated. We paid £7.19 million to get this guy from Manchester United. He's going to slot straight into the starting 11. Based on his overall, he is by far our best player at the moment. I'm extremely happy that I've managed to get this guy. We've also made another signing, Kyle Edwards. He was a free agent, so we just snapped him up. 23 years of age, 70 rated. I think he's going to be quite a good super sub for us because his overall rating is quite similar to our current wingers anyways. We've officially come to the end of the first transfer window in season two. This is the team that we're going ahead with. I think it's dramatically improved since the first season. There's only one player that isn't in the 70 overall rating, and that's our right back, who I believe at the midway point in the season will be touching the 70 overall rating. But who knows? We're in a better division now. We're in a more competitive division. It's not going to be a piece of cake like the third tier division was. Division 2 is a whole new kettle of fish. Let's see how we do. Guys, we're at the midway point in season 2. Take a look at where we are. We're third in the league, guys. I mean, we're 13 points away from first place, but I'd say that's a pretty solid start to the season. 9 wins, 5 draws and 4 losses. Considering we've just been promoted and we're already fighting for promotion in the Division 2, I would say that we're doing really, really well. We've just sold our first player of the second transfer window, Len Jaskrometsky. He's gone for 810,000. He wanted out. I had no choice in the matter. Good luck to him. Just sold another player, Widener. He wanted out of the club as well. I think this is all due to game time. We sold him for just over £1 million. Good luck to him. He's a decent player. He just didn't fit the team that wanted in the starting 11. We've just come to the end of the second transfer window in season 2. This is how the squad's looking. Next year, I definitely know where to bolster the team. We definitely need a better right back. I feel like the midfield on the left side of pitch could do with bolstering a bit. Markowski is letting the team down a little bit. Oberlin needs to pick his finger out his backside and start improving. The rest of the team, no, I'm quite happy with. Our right back, I would love to see him improve, to be totally honest with you, but we can only wait and see. He is still only 19 years of age, so we can't expect too much of him. Let's see how we look at the end of the season. Boys and girls, season 2 is just about to finish. We are finished 3rd, so we are currently in the playoffs for promotion. This could be huge. I don't know whether I want to go up or not, because I feel like if we go up, we'll come straight back down with the squad. I mean, it's a good squad, don't get me wrong, but is it Bundesliga quality? I don't know, but we'll have to wait and see. But we miss out on automatic promotion by 1 point. Can you believe that? 1 point. I believe the playoff is between ourselves, VfL Bochum, Greuther Fürth and FC Nürnberg. I mean, it could be any one of those, but I don't know how I feel about it. I mean, obviously, I want us to do well, but it could be a blessing in disguise staying in Bundesliga 2 in Season 3, bolstering the squad even more, giving it a bit more strength, and then trying for the Bundesliga. We come up against Hamburger SV in the playoffs. It's a two-leg fixture, this is, so I don't even know how I feel about this. I mean, I want us to do well, obviously, but do I want us to go up it with this squad? I mean, I feel like if we go up, we'll come straight back down. I would like another season in Division 2, but we'll see how we go on. Can we pull off an upset? I mean, it would be quite... Wait, what? Aggregate 3-3. I'm so confused right now. What's going on? Okay, bear with me. Right, okay, the 3-3 aggregate thing was just a complete glitch on the last one. The aggregate is 2-1. That's what threw me off. I genuinely didn't know what that was, because obviously it was the first leg of 2, and I was like, hey, how is it 3-3 already? But nevertheless, we're 2-1 down on aggregate. I genuinely don't have any feelings towards this. I mean, if we can pull it off, great. If not, oh well, we can move on in the next season in Bundesliga 2, build a squad even more, and then push for promotion. But we can see what we'll do here. Maybe we could pull off an upset. Oh, wow. You see what I mean? We got absolutely battered by Hamburger SV. Imagine if we came up against Bayern Munich. We wouldn't stand a chance. We remain in Bundesliga 2 for this season. I'll be honest with you though, guys. Bundesliga 2 has been quite tough on these guys because the stats are nowhere near as good as they were last year. Dejaku got 17 goals and 5 assists in 42 games. Orp did get 12 goals, fair play to him. But the overalls are increasing. They're improving. That's what I want more than anything, to be honest. The overalls are increasing like mad. And if I'm being totally honest, that is genuinely all I'm bothered about. I mean, the overalls make the team better. But still, it is... But by far and beyond one of our best players, 21 years of age, 77 rated. He's growing grown 9 in 2 seasons. That's ridiculous. Schnegg's coming in clutch for us, still 23 years of age, 74 rated. Lawrence, he's coming good. He's only 19 years of age as well. I'm going to keep hold of him. I think he's going to be quite good for us. But yeah, nevertheless, like, I mean, we just need to keep improving. Twansby's improved by 2, that's decent. Yeah, I mean, it's looking decent for next season. I'm very confident going into season 3. Let's get into it. The board has backed us a lot more this year. They've given us £22.24 million to spend. And taking a quick look at the squad, there's only a couple of places that I really want to bolster. The right back and our centre midfield role. And I think I know who to get. We made our first purchase season 3. Steven Session, the right back from Fulham, 22 years of age, 71 rated. He cost us only £4.3 million. I feel like in the grand scheme of things, that's a bargain. I feel like he's going to grow quite significantly this year. Well, I hope he does anyways, but there's one more player that we have to get. Ladies and gentlemen, help me welcome Arne Meyer to the team. 23 years of age, 78 rated. We bought this guy from Hertha Berlin for £17 million. And I think this guy is the final piece of the puzzle that we needed to gain promotion comfortably into the Bundesliga. And once we're in the Bundesliga, comfortably challenge. We've just been able to sign Oriol Busquets on a free. Sergio Busquets' little brother, I believe, 23 years of age, 71 rating. I'll be honest with you, he's more squad depth than anything else. I don't think he's going to get played, but he's there when we need him. Take a look at the team. Guys, I'm not going to lie to you, I'm much more comfortable and confident in this team than I was in the previous season. The right back position's looking a bit better. It's not the best, but he will grow. Maia slots perfectly right next to Stiller. I've got a good feeling about this season. I've got a very good feeling about this season. Let's jump to mid-season and see how we get on. So, guys, we're currently at the midway point in Season 3, and taking a look at the league, it doesn't look like we're going to go up as champions. Mainz are absolutely running away with it at the moment. Our only hope, realistically, as it stands, is to go second place. We're only 1 point off second place. We're just 1 point behind Dusseldorf. But, to be honest, that we're still in the top six, so it's a good sign. But yeah, realistically, we should be doing a lot better than this. Season 3's second transfer window has just ended, and this is how we're looking going into the rest of the season. The boys are improving as we speak. We have our first 80 rated player in still. I had a feeling it was going to be in 21 years of age and 80 rated. I've got a feeling if we can keep hold of him for the remainder of this video, he's going to go up massively still. But yeah, this like Oberlin needs to pick his feet up. Sessegnon needs to improve a little bit more before I'm happy. Him and Oberlin just need to improve a bit more, then I'll be happy with them. But overall, I'm extremely happy with how this team's improving. It's so good in comparison to how we started with a couple of seasons ago. Let's see how we finish this season off. At the end of Season 3, we officially enter the Bundesliga. We finished second. We finished 11 points behind Mainz. Like, we were never going to catch them. But we outdo Dusseldorf. We finished 9 points clear of third place, securing our spot in Bundesliga next season. I'm buzzing with that. Within 3 seasons, we've gone from the bottom tier to the top tier. I'd say that's pretty good going, to be honest. Once again, Arp is the top goal scorer. He's grown 4 again. That is ridiculous. Dejaku's grown 3. Oberlin's gone 2. Fair play, Oberlin. Is actually pulling his socks up now. Singh's gone up to 76. Stiller's 81 rated now. Twansby 79. They're all growing ridiculously well, and it's really good to see. Sessegnon 74 rated. He's still 22, so that's really good to see. But yeah, I mean, I can't fault them one little bit. On to Season 4 we go. We begin Season 4 with a total of £31.58 million to spend. Honestly, there's a couple of places that I would like to improve, but there's one place that I want to improve. I want to improve that winger spot. In a very, very shocking turn of events, Dejaku has put a transfer request in, and FC Porto have come in for him and bought him with his release clause, which I didn't even know he had. He's gone for £14.4 million. It's just blown my mind. We've gone up to Bundesliga finally, and now he wants to move. Honestly, you think you know people. Anyways, I'm genuinely going to go ballistic. Since when did all these players have release clauses? Singh's gone for £6.4 million. Oh my god, I'm an idiot. I cannot believe this. I need to start checking this. So now I need to buy a central attacking midfielder and a winger, all because I'm a dumb shit. We found our replacement winger, Rafael Camacho. He came from Sporting CP for £18 million on the dot. 23 years of age, 78 rated. I believe the Portuguese player is a perfect replacement. Just picked up Ethan Layard. He was a free agent, so all we had to do was pay his wages. I feel like it's a decent signing. 22 years of age, 74 rated. He's just decent for squad depth, if I'm being totally honest with you. We have finally found our replacement central attacking midfielder, Emmanuel Vignato. 23 years of age, 77 rated. The Italian cost us £14.5 million. I'm very happy that he's in our team. We're just going to get him onto developmental and grow him as much as we can. We've come to the end of Season 4's transfer. This is the team. This is how we're looking going into the Bundesliga. I'm quite happy with it. I did want to replace Obertan, but then obviously our right winger decided to jet off somewhere else, so we had to come up with Camacho and Vignato. Overall, I'm happy. I feel like we've got a good shot at doing well, to be honest. I mean, there's only a couple of areas in the starting 11 where we really need to bolster, the right wing and the left wing. Other than that, it's actually pretty solid. The only teams that we're really going to get annihilated against are the obvious ones like Bayern and Dortmund. So let's jump halfway through the season and see how we're doing. I'm not going to lie to you guys, we're in a bit of trouble here. We're literally third from bottom. We are third from bottom. This is not how I thought this season would go at all. I thought we'd do a little bit better than this. We've won 2, drawn 5, and lost 10. This is nowhere near good enough. Yeah, I've got no words for this. I'm genuinely in disbelief. I'm pretty sure some other teams have got worse quality in their teams that they're above us. but we're in the bottom three. I'm just hoping that for the remainder of the season, we can pull our socks up, pick our fingers outside of our backsides, and actually start playing football. Just to catch you guys up now, we've sold Bulchkar for 3.1 million, and we've also sold Edwards. Edwards never got played, and neither did Bulchkar, so we've just sold them to get rid of them, but we're going to bring another player in, I'm sure. We've just come to the end of the second transfer window in this season four. This is how the team is looking at the moment. It's pretty much unchanged. The guys are improving. I'm just praying that we don't go down at the end of the season. Thankfully, at the end of the season, we do remain in the Bundesliga after all. We finished 13th. It's still not the best place, but we did hit our objective by finishing mid-table. But yeah, for a first season, it was to be expected. We were never going to get top half football. We're never going to get Champions League. But we have to stay in the Bundesliga to progress, to get to that point anyway. Arp has had one hell of a season in terms of growth. He's grown 5 again. This guy is absolutely mental. Jan Fiet Arp is ridiculous, honestly. Rafael Camacho's done well to grow. Oberlin's growing. We might have to think of replacing him next year. Schnegg's growing as well. At 25, he's really doing well. Maier, he's remained the same. Tillman's grown. Lard's grown. Mai's grown also, 24 years of age. Twansby's also grown. Vignato's also grown. I can see him actually being a dark horse. I reckon he's going to grow quite significantly in the next couple of seasons. The boys have done all right. I mean, we finished mid-table. We're not down. We're still in the Bundesliga. But yeah, on to season 5. Season 5, we've been given a little bit more money. We've been given £33.02 million to spend. Taking a quick look at the team as well, there's one position I really want to work on this time, and it's that left wing spot. It's not good enough at all. The right back will improve, but Oberlin has had plenty of chances. I think he's reached his peak of potential. He's 26 and he's only 75 rated. It's just not good enough anymore. We've just made our first signing of the transfer window. Luis Enrique, the Brazilian from Marseille, has joined us for £15 million. 22 years of age, 78 rated. If you guys watch the Marseille rebuild, you know how good this guy is. We're going to put him on the left-hand side of the field in place of Oberlin, and hopefully he can progress as well as he did in the Marseille rebuild. Okay, something to catch you guys up on. We've sold Sessegnon and Busquets for a combined £11.6 million. Sessegnon's not as good as our current right-back, so we can say goodbye to him. And Busquets, he did his job. He was a good super sub for us, but now it's time to move on, and we can put that money to good use. We've officially come to the end of the first transfer window in season 5. This is how we're looking. The team is improving a little bit. I'm hoping we can do slightly better this season because obviously the team is progressing. And once we start doing better, the funds will come, and that's when we'll be able to proper invest in very good players and then start turning this team around. Let's skip to halfway through the season to see how we're doing. We're currently midway through season 5. We're sitting at 14th spot in the league. I'm not going to lie to you. It's better than where we were last year, so it's a definite improvement. But I want to be in the top half of the table now. That's where you get the real money. That's where you can actually start developing your team. We've jumped 2 spots from this time last year, so at least we have improved. Okay, guys, I'm catching up to do. So, Oberlin has finally been sold for £7.9 million. He's been a good servant to us. Best of luck to him in the future. But Vignato has also been sold for £35 million. That is what you call good business. So with this money, we're going to find replacements. We've just dipped our hands in our pockets and forked out big for Jamal Musiala, the 21-year-old German player from Bayern Munich. Has come to Bayern Munich too. 81 rated as well. £40 million he has just cost us. He is the perfect replacement for Vignato. Younger and better. This is the team that we're going to be rocking with for the rest of the season. For me now, it's only the left back and right back that need improvement. Everywhere else looks pretty solid. I feel like the rest of this season, we could actually impress ourselves and challenge for Europe if possible. If we can go on a good win streak, who knows what could happen. We've definitely got the potential. Our players are dramatically increasing. Arp and Stiller are running the show at the minute. And obviously with our new signing Musiala, he's only 21 years of age, so I'm expecting big things from that guy. Luis Enrique, I'm also expecting big things from. Let's see how we do at the end of the season. Just before I sim to the end of the season, I did some last minute transfers because they just got scouted. Take a look at transfer number one, Jose Recalme Reche, 20 years of age, 77 rated, the Spaniard. He was a free agent as well. This was amazing for me. He's a CDM, and take a look at his base stats. I think we found a hidden gem here, so we're going to put him all on developmental and see what we can do with them. Joining him is Samuel Letondo. The Belgian is 21 years of age, 76 rated. Again, I think this guy's going to be pretty decent. We're going to stick him on developmental to see where he is at the end of the season. Plus, with these two being in the centre midfield role, we don't have much squad depth there, so these two are literally perfect. They're both young and they both look like they've got decent potential. Also, Luka Netz is joining our team. He is going to be joining us when the transfer window opens next year in season 6. 21 years of age, 76 rated. The German cost us £14 million to get. He looks pretty decent, and I'm looking forward to replacing him with our current left back right now, because he looks to be like he could potentially be a lot better than our current left back. Right, now it's time to skip to the end of the season. I'm not going to lie to you guys, we finished exactly where we finished last year, and I'm very disappointed about it. I feel like our squad now is good enough to be getting into the top 10. I'm hoping that next year is the year that we break out of this bottom half finish spell and start reaching for Europe. As always, Arp is the top goal scorer. The main man, he's gone up to 85 now. I'm so happy I stuck with him. Camacho, he's grown one. Luis Enrique, he's gone to 81 rated. Brilliant stuff. But Musiala, he's gone to 83 and he's only 22 years of age. He's going to be a very good signing for us. But overall, I'm happy with the development that the players are doing so far. However, I want us to be finishing in better positions. I want us to be aiming higher in the league. Nevertheless, let's go into season 6. In season 6, the board have backed us a little bit more, giving us over £40 million to spend. If I'm going to be totally honest with you guys, I've got the left back sorted out with our new signing, but the right back position needs to be filled. Guys, we've just sold Angelo Stiller for £125.6 million. Oh my, I think that's the most we've ever sold someone for on this rebuild series so far. We're going to put that money to very good use. He's been an amazing player for us, but it's time for him to move on. What a goddamn replacement we have just bought. Jude Bellingham, 22 years of age, 83 rated. The Englishman from Dortmund cost us £72 million. I can't believe how good of a deal that actually is. If you know anything about this guy, you know how good he is and you know how good he's going to be in the coming seasons. We've just made our second signing of this transfer window. Ramon Pastor Vacas, the Spaniard, is 22 years of age, 82 rated. He cost us £50.7 million from Aston Villa. I've got a good feeling about this guy. If he's 22 years of age and already 82 rated, I'd love to see what he'll be like at the end of the season. We're going to convert him to a right back to replace Laird, and hopefully it'll work out quite well. We've successfully sold Arne Meyer for £28.7 million. The centre midfielder, he was 26 years of age and only 81 rated, I believe. So we've cashed in on him. So hopefully we can bring in someone a little bit younger and a lot better. We have found our replacement, Jeff Reine-Adelaide. The Frenchman cost us £50 million to buy him. 27 years of age and 84 rated. I've got a very good feeling about this guy. I can't wait to see how our team looks right now. We've officially reached the end of season 6's first transfer window, and take a look at the team. Now I am confident. Look at the midfield, look at the defense. Yes, the left back is a little bit hit and miss, but he will grow. He's only 22 years of age. Our team is young. Our team is very, very promising right now. Arp, he's just the leading man right now. I'm not going to lie to you. I'm so happy with how he's progressed. But yeah, I can't explain how happy I am with this. I'm very, very confident going into season 6. Let's skip to the halfway point. We're halfway through the season, guys, and we are finally in the top half of the table. We're only 1 point behind Bayern Munich themselves. RB Leipzig are actually top of the league. Dortmund are closely behind them. And then after that, I think it's just Dortmund and Leipzig running away with it at the minute. But I am extremely happy with how we are playing right now. So we've reached the end of the second transfer window. We've done no sales and we have made no purchases, purely because A, I don't really know where I would buy for. Obviously, the left back is a weakness, but I feel like if I give him a bit more time, he will just grow and grow and grow. And secondly, who would I buy anyway? I'm not even sure where I'd buy. Maybe next year I could invest in another centre-back. Twansby's going on now. He's 28 years of age and he's only 81 rated, so potentially another centre-back. Maybe a better winger partnership. I'm not sure, but everywhere else, I want to remain the same. Hopefully, this year will be the year we break into Europe. But who knows? We'll have to wait and see. Let's go to the end of the season. We are finally in Europe! Thank God for that! It only took us 6 seasons, but we have finally broke into Europe. Oh my God, thank the Lord for that. I knew we had it in us. We end up finishing in 6th place, 4 points clear of 7th. We were quite comfortable in the end. Oh my God, thank the Lord for that. Luis Enrique this year was our top goal scorer, finishing with 18 goals and 3 assists. Art was very close behind him, 1 off, 17 goals, 3 assists. Musiala, 8 goals, 4 assists. He is 86 rated now. What an absolute baller. Camacho, he is currently injured, but he scored 7 goals, 4 assists. Guys, Divaldon, bitch, Riquelme, Reche, the free agent, has gone to 81 rated. Beautiful stuff. Oh, God, boys, I'm buzzing. I'm absolutely buzzing. Pastor Vacas hasn't gone up at all, though, which is quite shocking to me. I'm not going to lie to you. I thought he'd have gone up like a rocket, but nevertheless. Nets has gone up like a rocket, though. He's gone up 4 this season. I knew he'd come in clutch here. But nevertheless, all the boys do go up, and we are finally in Europe. I'm buzzing with that. On to Season 7. In Season 7, the board has backed us tremendously, giving us just over £90 million to spend. Taking a quick look at the team, I want to improve our defence. I want to replace Tuansby with someone a lot better. Potentially buy another left-back as well. I don't know, actually, because he's 23 years of age. He's still got a lot of time to progress and improve, though. We've just signed the centre-back that we were after. Pasquale Casso, the Italian, cost us £67.6 million. We're getting to that point now in career mode where hardly any of the big names are left in this. And the young ones at the start of career mode are aging dramatically. So he is a lot of regens now. But he's 24 years of age, 84 rated. I've got a feeling that in a couple of years' time, he's going to be a sensational centre-back. Okay, guys, it's time to catch you guys up on something. So, unbeknownst to me, our keeper had a release clause. I had no idea about it. A team activated the release clause and bought him just like that without me even realising. I didn't even get an email. So, I've had to make a quick purchase. We have purchased the 31-year-old Spaniard Kepa for £16 million. He's 83 rated, so he's alright, to be honest. But next year, we will be looking for another keeper that is a lot better than Kepa. Made another signing in, Amad Diallo. The 23-year-old cost us £55.9 million. 83 rated at only 23 years of age. I'm hoping that this guy will improve dramatically as the seasons go by. We've reached the end of the first transfer window in Season 7. This is how the team is looking. It's so much better, in my opinion. Casso slots in nicely there. Diallo slots in lovely on the right-hand side of the pitch. Kepa, he's going to be all right for the season, I think. But next season, if we qualify for the Champions League, we are going to have to upgrade massively. But yeah, nevertheless. For the group stage of the Europa League, we're in Group F with RB Salzburg, Fenerbahce, and FCSB. I have zero clue who FCSB is. I do apologise if you support them, but I have no idea who they are. I'm hoping that we just wipe the floor with these guys. Our team realistically should do them. I mean, our quality right now is beyond brilliant. So I'm hoping that we go through top of the league. But I wouldn't mind going through... I just don't want to crash out. We've absolutely smashed it in the Europa League. Finishing top of the table. Winning 4, drawing only 2. Ourselves and Salzburg progressed to the round of 32. In the round of 32, we face Bologna. I'm not too sure what their team's like at the minute, but I'm sure it'll be a tricky game. In the Bundesliga, we are in the top 6 again, but we aren't actually that far off top 4. We're 1 point behind 4th. We're 2 points behind Bayern Munich. I mean, it's all to play for. I believe this year we'll be able to get Champions League. I'm going to be completely honest with you guys. Up until this point, I have completely forgot about the DFB Pokal. Yeah, this is a little bit awkward. But so far, we have made it to the quarterfinals. We're against Leverkusen. Hopefully, we can do bits in it. But yeah, I can't believe it's taken me 7 seasons to realise that. Bloody hell. We've just come to the end of the second transfer window. Take a look at the team, guys. They have come on leaps and bounds. Do you remember what this team was like at Season 1? There wasn't a single player over 70 rated. Now there isn't a single one under 83 rated. It's ridiculous. Guys, I've got a very good feeling about this season, seriously. Let's jump to the Europa League round of 32. We're in the Europa League now, away from home, in the round of 32 against Bologna. I mean, realistically, I don't know a single player on their team. I'm not even going to lie to you guys. I'm just hoping that we've got enough quality to put a put a shift in and hopefully get a result going into the second round. Can we do it? Yes, we get a 2-1. We get a 2-1 lead going into the second leg. It's now time for the second leg. We're at home this time. We're up 2-1 on aggregate against Bologna. I mean, look at our team. It is getting ridiculously good now. We just need our right back to pull his socks up and actually start improving a bit more. But can we go through to the next round of the Europa League? Yes, we can. We win 3-2. We have done it. We are through to the round of 16. Guys, you honestly can't write this. Look who we are against in the next round of the Europa League. We are up against our neighbours, Bayern Munich. Their team looks mental. Kimmich, Foden, Gnabry, Koeman, Alphonso, Davies, Theo, Hernandez. It's going to be a tough game. It's going to be a tough game. We are at home in this leg, but I'm hoping that we can pull off a result, pull off a shock upset. It's a 1-1 draw. That I will take. That I will definitely take. We've all got all the pressure going on us into the next leg. Let's see what we can do. Now time for the second leg against Bayern Munich, guys. We're basically 1-0 down on aggregate. They got the away goal, haven't they? We're away this time. We need a win to secure our place in the next round of the Europa League. Can we do it, guys? Can we pull off a major upset and knock out on it? We do as well! Oh my god! We knock out Bayern Munich! I told you we'd overtake them at some point. Come on! Now time for the quarterfinals, and we are against Real Sociedad. Now, these guys have got a habit of having a ridiculously good team at this part of the career mode. I've watched loads of rebuild videos, and for some reason, Real Sociedad just have an insane team at this part. We're away from home in the first leg. Our team is looking really good. They're all ready to go. All of them have got full energy. So let's go. Can we get an upper hand in the first leg? Can we do it? We get a 1-1 draw. We got the away goal. That is the most important thing. On to the second leg we go. Here we go, guys. It's the second leg of the quarterfinals. We've currently got the advantage with the away goal. Can we book our place in the semi-finals of the Europa League? Can we do it against Real Sociedad? Can we knock them out? We can as well. We are through to the semi-finals. Come on, boys. That is a very good result. On to the semi-finals we go. Who are we playing? Guys, we're playing against the Italian champions of this year, Inter Milan. The Italian giants. Look at their team as well. They have got a very good team. This is going to be a very, very tough challenge. But I do believe that we've got enough quality in the team to knock these guys out. We're home in the first leg. Can we pull off an upset? We beat them 2-0 in the first... Oh, my God. We beat them 2-0 in the first game. Come on, that's a brilliant start. This does put us at such an advantage going into the second leg. All we realistically need is a draw, and we're through to the final. Come on! We are one game away from securing our place in the Europa League final. We're up against Inter Milan again. We're 2-0 up on aggregate, so we couldn't go into this game with a better advantage. Can we knock off the Italian giants? Can we knock them out? Come on, Bayern. You know you've got it in you. Come on. We're through to the final. Come on, courtesy of a Musiala goal. We've done it. We've knocked out the Italian giants. We're through to the final. The question remains, though, who are we playing? Look who we're playing in the final. The team that I support, Chelsea. Now, taking a look at Chelsea's team, they've got Parrott. They've got Tony Parrott. Bloody hell. They've got Pulisic. They've got Mount Havert, Gilmore. Gilmore on the wing, that's an unusual one. Chilwell, he's got to be aging at this point. Lacroix, Christensen, Livramento, Kumbulla, Areola. I'm not going to lie to you, that's not the team that I expected Chelsea to have. I'm quite disappointed in Chelsea. I thought they'd have had a lot better of a team. But nevertheless, we go into this final in great spirits. Can we somehow knock off the English giants? Come on, can we book our place? We've just absolutely annihilated him. Come on! We are in the Champions League regardless of where we finished in the Bundesliga with a 3-0 convincing victory over Chelsea. That's brilliant. Let's see where we finished elsewhere. It's actually a very good job we've just won that game against Chelsea because we didn't even qualify for the Champions League. We finished fifth. So we would have gained Europa League again, but not Champions League. So we are into the Champions League next year, I believe, because we won the Europa. But we would not have qualified if we hadn't have won. I think we'll take Borussia Mönchengladbach's role in the Champions League, though, due to the fact that we won the Europa League. Leverkusen and Mönchengladbach will be in the Europa League next year, I believe. We went on to win the DFB Pokal against Hoffenheim in the final 1-0. That's brilliant. So we won the Europa League this year, and we've won the DFB Pokal. That is brilliant stuff. That is brilliant stuff. Harper's going down in the Hall of Fame of the Rebuild series so far. Look at how he has grown. He's 89 rated. He's insane. 27 goals in the Bundesliga, but overall we got 37 goals and 7 assists with him. Marcelia is 88 rated at 24 years of age, bagging himself 19 goals and 8 assists. Luis Enrique, 17 goals, 8 assists. Camacho, 9 goals, 2 assists. Jude Bellingham, 7 goals, 14 assists. Dalio didn't have that great of a season, but he's improved too, and he scored 4, assisted 2. Guys, I'm not going to lie to you. My is 90 rated overall. This is insane. I've got a very good feeling about next season. I genuinely do believe if we have a good season next season, we can potentially win the Champions League. On to season 8. We are now in season 8. The board has backed us and then some. £179.5 million. Now, taking a very quick look at the team, I want to replace Kepa with someone a lot better, and I want to replace one of the wingers. I'm not too sure yet. It might be Luis Enrique we go to replace. I'm not too sure. Diallo does look to be incredible. 24 years of age and 85 rated as well. So it might be Luis Enrique that bats the bullet. We've just made our very first signing of the transfer window. Martin van der Voort, 25 years of age, 85 rated. Belgian cost us £65.6 million to get. I'm very happy with this guy. I'll be honest, at this stage in career mode as well, season 8 is one of the best keepers to buy at this point as well. So I'm extremely happy he's now in our team. We've just had the bargain of the century, guys. Bukayo Saka, the Englishman from Arsenal, he has come to Bayern Munich too for £94.1 million. With him being 25 years of age and already 88 rated, I can't believe we got him for under £100 million. I feel like we just robbed PSG blind there. We just sold a first player, Jeff Reina. Adelaide, we sold him for £85.8 million. He was 29 years of age and only 85 rated. He was steadily declining as well, so we've managed to get quite a bit of money for him, but I think we can find a suitable replacement. We've certainly found a suitable replacement. Meet Billy Gilmore, the Scotsman, is 26 years of age, 86 rated. He cost us £81.5 million. This guy is one rating higher than Rain Adelaide was, and he's 3 years younger, so I feel like we've got a better deal here, and I'm very, very excited to have him in our team. We've just come to the end of the first transfer window in season 8. This is how our team is looking going into this season. It's looking pretty damn good, if I'm being totally honest with you. I've got high hopes for this season. It might be the season where we do end up winning the Champions League. I do hope so. I mean, it's about bloody time, don't you think, guys? But there's a lot of potential in this team. They're all growing at a very good pace as well. I'm just excited to see what we can do this season, to be honest. In the Champions League, we haven't exactly got it easy. We're up against Chelsea, Marseille and CSKA Moscow. If we aren't careful, we could potentially go out for the first time in this rebuild series in the knockout stages of the Champions League. I'm hoping that really isn't the case, though. I really do not want that to be the case at all. But I suppose we'll have to wait and see. Let's skip to the midway points. Guys, this group is actually insane. Take a look at this. So ourselves and Chelsea, we both have goal difference of 5. So we go through basically joint top. Marseille, they have 4 goal difference and they go out just because they didn't score one more goal. I wonder what would have happened if they'd have scored one more. That would have been mental. CSKA Moscow got their arses handed to them. They lost all their games, conceded 17. 17 goals in 6 games. That's ridiculous. But nevertheless, we go through. But now we have to find out who we're playing in the round of 16. Okay, so we play the oil company from France, PSG, the powerhouses of France football. That's going to be a tough one, to say the least. That is going to be a very tough game. In the Bundesliga, we're actually doing quite well. We're nowhere near top spot, but we're 2 points behind our neighbours, Bayern Munich. That says a lot of how far we've come in quite a short amount of time since being in the Bundesliga. It's actually ridiculous how good we've become. We're joint third with Leverkusen, but we're beating them obviously on goal difference. But yeah, we're doing really well in the Bundesliga. In the DFB Pokal, we're up against Greuther Fürth in the quarterfinals. Hopefully we can beat them and make it to the finals. It would be nice to win the DFB Pokal again. We've come to the end of the second transfer window in Season 8. Take a look at how this team is shaking up, guys. I think literally everybody has improved. Arps now 92. Musiala is 90 rated. Mai is 91. Queso is 88. Luis Enrique's had to burst his way back into the team because he's now 87 rated over Diallo, who is 85 rated. Saka's gone up to 89 rated. Guys, this is the year we win the Champions League. Mark my words, this is the year we do it. With that being said, we are now in the round of 16 tie against PSG. The first leg, we are away from home. That team is just mental, isn't it? Mbappe, Neymar, Reina Adelaide, our old boy, Tierney, Marquinhos, Ginter is a questionable choice, I must say. Sabitzer, Silva. I'm not too sure with Wijnaldum and Vichar. I can't even pronounce his name. I just really hope we don't lose dramatically against PSG, man. I just want us to do well. A draw here would satisfy me greatly. If we could get a draw or maybe steal a win. Steal a win. We've just battered PSG on their home turf. Holy shit. Guys, this is the year. I'm telling you, this is the year that we bring it to Bayern Munich too. I'm telling you right now. Let's go on to the second leg. Now time for the second leg against PSG in the round of 16. We're currently 3-1 up on aggregate. PSG, I've got a mountain to climb in this game. Can we book our place in the quarterfinals of the Champions League? Hopefully we can. We lose 1-0, but that does mean that we go through because of aggregate. So we win 3-2 on aggregate. Onto the quarterfinals we go. Come on. We've drawn the Spanish giants themselves, Real Madrid. Now take a look at their team. Vinicius Jr., Rodrigo, Odegaard, Blanco, Konate, Hermoso, Agu, Courtois, Mendy, Raul, Pedro. Guys, this is a very, very, very strong Real Madrid side. I'm going to be totally honest with you. This could be the one where we go out. I'm not going to lie to you. I'm not confident going into this. But can we overthrow the Spanish giants? Can we? It ends in a draw. Saka misses a penalty, which could come back and really bite us in the arse going into the second leg. But it looks like we dominated the stats more than they did. So it does look quite promising going into the second leg. With that being said, into the second leg we go. Guys, this one's going to be a very, very tricky game. But I do have faith in the boys that we can pull this one out of the bag. I'm hoping and praying that we can, because this Real Madrid team is fierce. Can we pull off the impossible? Can we not? We've done it! Come on! We knocked them out on away goals. We progress to the semi-finals. I can't believe we have just pulled this one out of the bag. Come on! We're now in the semi-finals against Liverpool, the team that just loves to win the Champions League. I don't think we've actually played against Liverpool in the Champions League yet. I think this is the first time playing against them. But Jesus Christ, that team that they're rocking with is insane. But I've got to say, at this point in career mode, surely some of those players have got to be in their 30s now. They've got to be dropping in overall. But nevertheless, Trent Alexander-Arnold, they've got Barella, Gravenberch. We all know how good he is. They've got Syed. I believe he's a regen. I think I've seen him before. I think he's Egyptian, so he might be Mo Salah's regen. Richarlison, Fabinho's got to be at least 34 now, surely. But yeah, this is going to be a ridiculously top game. Hopefully the boys can pull one out of the bag and give us an advantage. Oh, it's another 0-0 draw. This isn't what we want, lads. This isn't what we want. I don't want to. This is horrible. This is genuinely horrible. We go into the second leg with no advantage. Hopefully we can do what we did to Madrid and we just do enough to book our place in the final. Let's go into the second leg. It's now the second leg of the semi-finals against Liverpool, the English giants of Europe. We go into this second leg 0-0 on aggregate. It's all to play for, but the question remains, can we book our place in the finals? Can Bayern Munich 2 book their place in... Oh my God! We don't just book our place in the finals. We book it convincingly. We have absolutely annihilated Liverpool in their own back garden. Now the question remains, who are we playing in the final? We're playing against Spanish giants Atletico Madrid in the final. Oh my God, that is going to be a very, very tough game. I can see Atletico Madrid having one hell of a goddamn team. But before we do get into the Champions League final, let's take a look at how we've actually done this season. We do end up finishing third in the Bundesliga. Bayern Munich take the top spot. Dortmund finished 4 points behind them. And then we finished 4 points behind Dortmund. But Leverkusen, they finished 14 points behind us. It was really a two-horse race, let's be totally honest. But Bayern Munich have always had a very strong hold over German football. They're just too goddamn good, man. We go out in the quarterfinals of the DFB Pokal. We lose to Greuther Fürth 5-4 on penalties after a 3-all draw. That's disappointing when you think about it, but nevertheless, at least they got to the final, I suppose. Bayern Munich did end up winning it in the end. Bayern Munich, for whatever reason, were in the Europa League last year. They must have finished outside the top four. That's crazy to think. And they beat Arsenal, of all teams, 5-4 on penalties. That's an unrealistic scoreline. Let's be honest. If Bayern played against Arsenal, it'd be something like 8-2, wouldn't it? Guys, I'm just going to put this out there. If you are needing a striker that is just guaranteed to get better and better and better every single goddamn season of career mode, just get Art, man. Look at how good he's become. He's going 4 in season 8. He's 93 rated, scoring 36 goals and getting 3 assists this season so far. Luis Enrique, he's 87 rated now. We lost faith in this guy at the start of the season, bear in mind. We brought Bukayo Saka to replace this guy, and he ended up fighting for his position and ended up back into the starting lineup. 19 goals and 8 assists for the Brazilian. Jude Bellingham getting himself 10 goals, 6 assists. Musiala, 8 goals, 13 assists. Camacho bagging himself 5 goals. Saka getting 4 goals and 10 assists. It's crazy how much this team has come on since the first season. There wasn't a single player over 70 rated, and now the entirety of this squad is just solid, let's be totally honest. This is how Atletico Madrid line up against us in the final. They got Joao Felix up top, Sané, Milinkovic-Savic, Neves, Chiesa, Goretzka, Lodi, Vardiol. Hey, the big boy Vardiol. If any of you guys have watched my Stoke City career mode, you'll know how much I love that guy. Torres, Kabore, and Jan Oblak. That is one hell of a team, guys. Our team remains unchanged. I'm not messing with it at all because this is the team that's got us to the final. But the question remains, can we make Bayern Munich 2 not only Champions League winners, but the best team in the world? Let's find out. Atletico are pushing us back so much, man. I can't get near the goal. This is ridiculous. We find Luis Enrique on the wing. Can he get it inside to Bellingham? Bellingham takes a touch. He brings it to Arp. Arp. Oh! Arp, he's still got the ball. He's still alive. Can we find Billy Gilmore? We can. Oh, we get dispossessed. Can we find Arp? Yes, we can. Oh, my God. Arp's through. Arp is through. If I know him, this is a goal. Yep, it's 1-0 already. Arp is never, ever missing from that position. The man is too goddamn good. 1-0 to Bayern Munich 2. That is mental to say. Luis Enrique. Oh my God, he's doing the entire team here. He's going to find Gilmore. Gilmore is going to find Saka. Saka is going to make this 2-0. And that's 2-0. The flag stays down. I thought that was offside, but Saka makes it 2-0 to Bayern Munich 2 within 14 minutes. Guys, I can see this being an absolute battering if Atletico Madrid aren't careful. They aren't playing well at all. We make it 2-0. Come on, the boys. I think EA need to make a better difficulty than Ultimate Man, because honestly, every time I play these finals, it's too easy. Every time I play a final, it is almost double digits. Saka's made that run down the left-hand side of the pitch. He's waiting for me. Oh my God, what a ball. Oh my God. Nah, that is too much, man. That is too goddamn much, man. That ball in from Saka, the finish from Arp, it's just, oh my Lord. Just take a look at this. Saka's patiently waiting for Arp to get in front of the defender. He gets in front, leaves his defender for dead, and Arp, oh my God. The keeper had absolutely no chance. It is 3-0 inside the first half. Guys, is it too early to say we've won? Musiala's got the ball back. What can Musiala do? Can he find Arp? Yes, he can. Arp is going to go through. What can Arp do here? Can he go all the way? It's just that easy. It is just that goddamn easy. 4-0 in 30 minutes, guys. Like, they need to make a better difficulty because this just isn't good enough. We are too good for Ultimate. Go back in the video before we went into the final and double check it's Ultimate because I promise you it is. We make it 4-0 before half time, guys. 4-0. Oh my god! Oh my god! Boys, I did not think that was going to go in. I just hit it. But, mate, whatever this guy touches turns to gold. I genuinely thought that was going nowhere. That's why I was so quiet. But look at that! I think every shot Arpa's had has gone in. Like, the keeper is just... That's Jan Oblak as well in goal. The keeper is standing absolutely no chance. Like, oh my god, Arpa's too good, man. It's scary how good he is. 4 goals in the first half for Arpa alone. Just take a look at the stats. We've absolutely dominated Atletico. Like, what more can we say? This game is ours. We are not losing this. I'm aiming for double figures. Let's get it. Musiala on the ball. Can we find Arpa? Arpa, we can find Arpa, but we find Luis Enrique. Luis Enrique, is he going to go all the way? Oh, Jan Oblak makes a great save. Saka is on the ball. Saka is going to take it. He's going to give it to Arpa. Arpa is going to put... Oh, bloody hell, Oblak. Just let us have one more, will you, please? You haven't been playing ball with us in the second half. Billy Gilmore retrieves it. Musiala. Can we get... Oh, for God's sake. I tell you what. Atletico Madrid have been playing really well in the second half. I haven't been able to score past them at all. Where was this fight in the first half? I wanted a challenge. Musiala. Can we get a sixth? Oh my god, please. Oh, for the love of God, we can't score. We genuinely can't score, guys. There we have it. Full time. It is 5-0 to Bayern Munich 2. Make sure you leave a comment down below to tell me which team you want me to rebuild next. I have just proven that I will do any and all teams. No matter what the budget is, no matter how bad the team is, I will make them Champions League winners by the end of the video. If you guys enjoyed today's video, be sure to leave a like, smash that subscribe button. I know that this one's been a long one. Thank you guys for sticking around till the end. I do appreciate it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, I'll see you later.